After starting the program, the window of step 1 appears. In this window, we must select the materials of the double layer and set the central wavelength and angle of incidence of the incident radiation. If the angle of incidence is greater than the angle of total internal reflection, this program will also calculate the thickness of the final layer to support surface optical waves. But in the first example, we will not calculate the final layer, supporting surface optical waves, but only calculate the reflection and transmission for normal incidence, that is, set rho equals 0. As you can see, as soon as we set the angle of incidence to be less than the angle of total internal reflection, the third layer disappeared. Now, to move on to step 2, we need to do the main action in step 1, select the thicknesses of the alternating layers. In this example, we will choose quarter wavelength layer thicknesses. Now the button to go to step 2 is active, we press it and go to step 2. In this step, we must choose the number of layers for our structure. We can also change the composition and thickness of the layers as we please. But in this example, we will leave everything as it is, and will calculate the spectral transmission in the wavelength range indicated here. We have obtained the expected transmission and reflection spectrum of our structure. Note that we can always go back to the previous step and change our structure. Let's double one of the quarter wave layers and get a transmission peak due to this half wave layer. We can also get the spatial distribution of the electromagnetic field inside the multilayer structure. We can also calculate the dispersion of this structure. In the following examples, we will consider more complex structures that support surface optical waves on the surface of a one-dimensional photonic crystal.